Okay, Charlie Brown, I'll hold this football and you run up and kick it.
I don't know.
Hi everyone. Doing a little research here, getting ready for my next big cartoon class. Well, welcome to Peanut Sketch School. My name is Noel, and I'm going to be your art teacher here in just a moment. Today, we are learning how to draw the world's crabbiest fussbudget, Lucy Van Pelt. Whoa, crank up the attitude for this one, people. This is going to be a lot of fun. Before we get going, just a few little tips on how to do Sketch School well. The best thing about doing these videos is you get to work at your own pace. If at any time you get confused during the sketching process, you can always hit pause and back it up and watch a step again. If I'm going too fast, if you think you miss a spot, you can even freeze frame the image on screen and draw right off it. The beauty here is you get to work at your own pace, and that'll help out a lot. Also, I highly recommend you don't do this alone. Get some other folks around you to draw with you. The best thing about doing Sketch School at one of our parks, at the end of each class, we all hold up our own drawings, and then everyone looks around and sees how everyone else did. It's really awesome sharing your artwork. And man, I really love looking at artwork. Now, for today's project, you're gonna need a few simple art supplies, things you have around your house. First of all you need is a pencil. Hands down, the cartoonist's best friend. I recommend a nice soft lead. There'll be a number 2 on your pencil showing that it's a soft lead, but that doesn't really matter. Any pencil will do. Also, if you have markers or crayons or pens, those will work too. What you're not gonna need is an eraser. We're doing a rough sketch for our project. I'll talk a bit more about that as we get into the drawing process. And the next thing you're gonna need, the other favorite thing a cartoonist loves in life, blank paper. When I was a kid, no lie, this was one of my favorite toys. I loves blank paper. All right, I think that's about it. Get ready to put on your crabby face. It's time to draw Lucy. Pencils up, it's officially cartoon time. Ha ha! All right, cartoonist, step number 1. In the middle of that big old blank piece of paper, lightly sketch in a circle that's about as big as an orange. Now I got some tips. First, keep it light. And here's the big one, you're not writing. Most folks are used to writing, and when you do that, you only use your wrist and you make these little itty bitty short chipping strokes. I'm using my whole arm and my wrist, and I'm very lightly drawing curved lines, which I'm then blending together with more curved lines to sculpt and shape this thing. So if there's something you don't like, don't start over, but instead just draw right over it and adjust it that way. Pretend you're sculpting, but on a flat surface. I'm gonna round this out a little bit, make it bigger, make it smaller, keep reworking and adjusting things. And whatever you do, don't stress out and try and make a perfect circle. This is all about having a little fun here today. All right, got something round on our page. Ready for step number 2. Next step makes this a lot easier. I'm gonna add some guidelines. From the top of Lucy's head to the bottom, very lightly, I'm gonna divide this in half. This tells me this is the front facing side of the shape. When I used to work as an animator, that was one of the most important lines to always be aware of. I'm also gonna go right to left with another guideline. Basically, gang, we're putting a big old plus sign right on top of this here shape. This shows us the center of it. That's where little Lucy's nose is gonna go. And also, we now have 4 smaller spaces to start putting things instead of this one big one. We've got a better shot at getting stuff where we want it. Now, the first feature I like to draw is the nose. That's the center of the head. And when you really know where that is, it's easier to start putting the other stuff around it in the right spot. Now her nose is kind of a bent letter C. I'm gonna have my Lucy looking this way. So starting right here in the center. Her nose is shaped just a little bit different than Charlie Brown's. Lucy's meant to be a little bit older than Charlie Brown. She's one of the bigger kids. She's also quite bossy, and as she puts it, she's quite crabby. I have a right to be crabby. There we go. Now, something that really separates her from Charlie Brown and Sally is the shape of her head. Now, their heads are just circles. If we were drawing Sally or Charlie Brown, we'd be good to go. But Lucy and Linus have this cute little indent on the side of their head that shows their cheek. I'll show you how to add this. I'm going to start right up here at the top of the old circle. And this is just a curved line here, gang. We're going to shave a little bit off of our main shape. Snip. Get rid of that. Snip. There we go. Drawing is so much like sculpting. Taking things on, putting things off. Pretend it's a piece of clay. In fact, you can even blend this right over here into the circle. Nice and round. See, there's her cheek. Oink! Classic Lucy Van Pelt. Next step is to add the ears. And the ears, well, these are pretty much like that nose. They're letter C's. These go on the sides of her head, however. Here's a trick on all Peanuts characters, this is true. The bottom of the nose will always line up with the top of the ear. Starting right there, that's where the top of that ear is gonna hit. And this is just the letter C. Nice and round. Think of that like a little coffee cup handle you're just snapping on there. Now I'm gonna do the same over here. This one, I'm gonna make just a little bit smaller. There we go, see how are her cheeks in front of that? Nice and round. We're gonna get that hair on there too in just a moment, Lucy. It's starting to look like Lucy? Yeah, maybe a little bit. Let's wake her up. Now her eyes, this is true of all Peanuts characters, they sit on either side of the nose, just below the top of the nose and really close to it. For us, that's gonna be here and here. Now here's the trick, gang. You wanna keep these eyes close to the nose. If they get above the nose or off to the side, she's gonna start looking a little more grown up. And those are just dots. Her actual eyes are little circles. These are shapes, and really treat them like a circle. Really draw a good circle on here, and then color it in nice and dark. In my opinion, the eyes are the most important part of one of these comic strip characters. People always look into each other's eyes when they communicate with each other. Likewise, when they're reading a comic strip or watching a piece of animation, they always look the characters in the eyes. Think of these like little actors up on your screen or on your newspaper page. Now, eyes this small are hard to show expressions on. And Charles Schulz was kind of clever how he did this. On either side of Lucy's eyes, he would always frame them up with these little curves. Here's where we start looking like a Peanuts character. And these can squash or stretch depending on her mood. If Lucy gets really cranky, they bend down. Or if, oh no, she gets mad, they can go way up if she's yelling at somebody. She yells a lot. And directly above her eyes are her eyebrows. The trick here, gang, eyebrows always need to be above the eye. Like I was saying, they can bend down, they can bend up. But if they drift off to the side where they're no longer above the eye, you're gonna lose any chance of having an expression. She's looking. What is Linus doing this morning? He's not getting ready for school. Hey guys, do it out there. Is this hard? Are you stressed? Are you having fun? I hope you're having fun. Drawing should be relaxing and fun. All right, we need some hair and we need a mouth. Now before we get that hair on, let's just take a moment and close off the circle. Let's go from the cheek to the ear. In fact, I'm even gonna shave a little bit off of my circle. Looks a little bit big to me here, the way we've got this going. That is the beauty of sketching here, folks. You can continually adjust your shapes as you're going. That first line that you put down doesn't always have to be the line that you use. Again, I think so many of us don't go on to draw because we learn to write at such an early age. Writing needs to be neat and precise. Drawing, it's all about building and adjusting until you find what you want. All right, it's time for a hairstyle. Now for the hair, we're gonna break this down into shapes here, people. That's gonna make this a lot easier. The main shape on Lucy's hair, she has a big teardrop that hangs right off at the front here. And remember how we drew that circle really light and loose? See, I drew the features darker because they're more definite. We're building another shape, so get just a little looser here. Just above that eyebrow, stay sketchy. Nice and round teardrop shape here. Think of this like a jelly bean. Boink. It's just a curved line and a curved line, really. It's a squashed version of your circle. This is the front of Lucy Van Pelt's hair. Now, for the front part where it goes over her forehead, we're gonna need two curved lines. Starting right here, just curve right on over to your center line. And then another one. Kind of like a letter W, you can think of it that way. Curvy line, curvy line. And then I'm just gonna close this up from this curve down to this ear. Nice and round. Whoop. There we go. Starting to look like Lucy. She doesn't look crabby. I always like it better when she's in a good mood. And then to close this off, all we need is a curve. Basically, we're gonna follow the line that we drew for the head right along here. Just go a little beyond it. That's a big mistake a lot of newer artists make. They make the hairline and the headline the same. When I was an animator, I always like to think of the hair as almost like a hat. See, that head is inside the hair shape. A hair hat. That's a weird for you. All right, got that lump. And then on the sides over here, her hair is always tucked behind her ears. And remember how we drew this jelly bean shape? We're gonna do the same, but just below those ears. And over here, whoop. See, that's all behind there. You're not seeing all of it. And on this side as well. Lucy has got a huge crush on Schroeder. She always sits at the edge of his piano and bothers him while he's trying to practice his Beethoven. All right, time for the mouth. Now this is a trick. All Peanuts characters' mouths are in the same spot, right between the bottom of the ears. The nose lines up with the top of the ears. Well, guess what, gang? That mouth lines up with the bottom of the ears. Straight across here. And Lucy's mouth, it's just as wide as these curves are on the side of her head. Just below that curve there and there. That's for the corners of the mouth. Now you could draw the mouth closed straight. You could draw a big open mouth like she's talking. You could give her a smile. I'm gonna draw her smiling. I like my Lucy in a good mood. You draw two curves here. These are little smile lines. When you smile, your mouth pushes your cheeks up. These little creases form. And the smile, just play a game of connect the dots with a nice curve here. Look at that. She is not in a bad mood at all. And the last thing I'm gonna add is her neck. Just below the nose here, this is nothing more than a tube, gang. For us, this is two straight lines, here and here. All the Peanuts have a big head and a skinny little neck. And you close it with a curve. This is the top of the dress here, where that head pops out. And her collar is just these two little curves. Here we go. And the last step, this is optional, but I totally recommend you do it. Take a moment and shade in that hair. Now check this out, cartoonists. I'm using the side of the pencil, not the point of it. This turns your pencil pretty much into a crayon. Perfect for shading. Gonna lay in a tone here. Da, 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 da. Color this in, get her ready to go to school. The harder you press down, the darker that tone will be. This is perfect for filling in areas in shadow on your sketches, your comics, or your cartoons. There we go. Hey, wait a minute. We did this. We just drew our very own picture of Lucy Van Pelt. Last step here, cartoonists. Take just a moment and sign your name. You just drew Lucy. Man, I never get tired of drawing Lucy. To be honest, when I was a kid, I was a little scared of her. In fact, I was scared of most kids that were older than me. Well, thanks a lot for drawing with me. I hope you had a lot of fun. And man, I sure hope you keep practicing. The more you practice, the better you get. Nobody ever starts to draw and gets worse at it. It's kind of the way it works. Until next time, stay sketchy.